I think dogs, kids, and cars. If you can talk to anybody about dogs, kids, and cars, you find something to talk about. And if you can start on that level where it doesn't seem scary, like, tell me the story of your life, or why did you rape that woman, or whatever the hard question is, if you could start out knowing that, oh, this person's a dog person too, or this person has kids, and kids are a huge connector because all of a sudden, I'm not just a journalist, I'm a mom, and they get something about me. I think that's the hardest part of all, is trying to figure out how to get someone to let you in and be intimate and share things, but let them remember that you're still a reporter. Because a lot of times people tell me stuff they haven't told their husband or their kids or their grandmother. And you have to develop that trust. You have to get them to let you in. But then it's really hard not to care too much. I remind people both by saying, like, don't forget I'm a reporter, you know, and holding up my badge, or, you know, brandishing my notebook so they'll remember that I'm taking notes and writing things down. I don't want them to forget, you know, that I'm there as a reporter. And sometimes it's really hard on the other end to extricate yourself. You've gotten in so far with somebody and you write their story and then they want to be your friend. Many of the people I write about are real lonely and want that connection, and I've probably given them more time and listening than they've had in a long time, and it's hard to be like, nope, I'm writing your story and I'm done. My ultimate goal really is to get into your bedroom. I mean, that sounds kind of like a lot to ask, but if I only have that one time with you at your house, I'll usually start out by saying, will you take me on a tour of your house? And, you know, they'll start out in the living room or the kitchen, and I'll ask about art on the walls or books on the shelf or plants they're growing or, you know, whatever it is, and then ultimately hope that they'll walk me up to their bedroom. So usually that'll be the last place you end up on the tour, which is kind of a natural place to say, okay, well, let me sit down and ask you a few questions. But I think if you get someone in their bedroom, it's the most intimate place you can possibly interview a person. It's the place usually that they're the most comfortable. It's the place that's the most personal, where you're going to see their dirty laundry or their stacks of bills or their unwritten novel they haven't finished, or that the dog gets to sleep on the bed, or, you know, some of these things that you might not even think to ask somebody about. I feel that's where a lot of masks come off.